Okay, once again I'll go through the exercise number 24. The following data have been extracted from the books of Lakshmi Industry for the year 93. This is the information for 1993, 1 year information. Then opening stock, purchase of raw material, closing stock, you adjust in the material. Carriage inward added to material. Other direct expense, it is the third item in the prime cost. Direct wages, direct labor. Indirect wages, factory overhead. Rent and rates, office goes to office overhead. Rent and rates, factory goes to factory overhead. Indirect consumption of material, it is a factory overhead. Depreciation on plant and machinery, factory overhead. Depreciation on office, office overhead. Then salary, office goes to office overhead. Salary, salesman goes to selling and distribution overhead. Other factory expense goes to factory overhead. Manager remuneration, it is administration in general. Okay. Otherwise, you have to follow the instruction. So, in the adjustment, in the paragraph, the manager salary, manager as overall charge of the company, his remuneration is to be allocated 14,000 to factory, 7,000 to office, and 3,000 to selling and distribution. Therefore, 24,540 you allocate between factory, administration, and office according to given instruction. Then office expense goes to office and administration, bad debt, selling and distribution, advertising, selling and distribution, carriage and freight outward. Outward is related to sales. So selling and distribution, traveling expense, selling and distribution, sales, last item, advance income tax related with income. It is non-cost item. So we will not take in the cost sheet. 24. Example number 25. In the example number 25, I already explained this one. Okay. Raw material manufacture means it is direct material. A raw material in the primary packing, it is also direct material. Material used in factory, it is a factory overhead. Raw material used in selling the product, selling and distribution overhead. Material used in office, office and administration overhead. Labor required in producing, this is the direct labor. Labor required in factory supervision, indirect labor comes to factory overhead. Direct expense, third item. Indirect expense, factory goes to factory overhead. Administration expenses goes to administration overhead. Depreciation on office building and equipment goes to office and administration. Okay. Then depreciation on factory building, factory overhead. Selling expense, selling and distribution. Freight on material purchased, it is added to material cost. You add to the material cost. It is a purchase expense. Advertisement, selling and distribution expense. And profit required is 20% on sales. Therefore, you add profit 20% on sales. That is total cost into 20 divided by 80. Okay. And example number 26. You see the example number 26. In the example number 26, they have made the two part. Okay. You take according to your requirement. Raw material, then finished stock. One. Opening. These are to be added. stock on 31st 12 98. These two items deducted. Raw material purchase add in the material. Work in progress, opening added, closing deducted in the factory overhead. Sales last item. Direct wages second item. Factory expense, factory overhead. Office expense, administration overhead. Selling expense, selling and distribution. Distribution expense, selling and distribution. These two, selling expense and distribution expense, comes under the selling and distribution overhead. Okay. And they asked to calculate the percentage. For the percentage purpose, factory overhead percentage is equal to factory overhead divided by direct labor into 100. And administration overhead percentage is equal to administration overhead divided by factory cost into 100. These are the basic percentage we calculate in the cost sheet. Okay. Then example number 27, they have given the trading profit and loss account. From the trading profit and loss account, you have to collect your required costs. Whatever cost items are there in the trading profit and loss account, you take the cost related item and leave the non-cost items. Okay. Opening stock, first item, add purchase of raw material, less closing stock of raw material 10,000. You deduct the closing stock of raw material 10,000. Okay. Carriage inward, add to the material. Opening stock, purchase, add carriage inward, less closing stock. Is called material consumed. Then wages is the direct wage, second item. Direct expense 4,000. You take the total of these three, you will get prime cost. Add factory overheads, factory expense, you will get factory cost. Add office expense, you will get cost of production. Add selling and distribution expense, you will get cost of sale. Then you leave one line, take the sale, then you will get the profit. Okay. The same 39,200 profit you will get in the cost sheet also, because there are no cost, non-cost items in the trading profit and loss account. And example number 28, I already solved this problem. 28 number is already solved. And 29 number is same as 28. I will not go for explanation. 28 solved, 29 same as 28 number. Okay. Then regarding tender, 30 number is already solved. 31 is also solved. 32 is also solved. I solved the 32 number problem also. Okay. Then 33 is also solved. I think it is solved one. 33. And 34 number. You see the example number 34. In the example number 34, in July 1990, manufacturing company was required to quote for a contract of, I think it is also solved on 34 number 500 fans. 34 is also solved. I think 32 number not solved. I'll explain the 32 number example. Example number 32 you see. From the following particulars, you are required to prepare statement showing prime cost, work cost, cost of production, percentage of factory overhead to wages, percentage of office overhead on work cost. Okay. You take the opening stock, add purchase, opening stock of raw material, add purchase, less closing stock of material. You will get the material. Then you take the productive wage, that is direct wage. Total of material consumed and direct wage is called prime cost. To that, you add factory overhead, you will get the factory cost. Add office overhead, that will give you cost of production. To that cost of production, add opening stock of finished goods less closing stock of finished goods. You will get cost of sale. And sale is there. Selling expenses are not given the problem. Therefore, you take the sale and ascertain the profit. Profit. It is the first one. Then percentage you calculate. Factory overhead percentage is equal to direct labor divided, factory overhead divided by direct wages into 100. That is, factory overhead is 2,58,000 divided by 10,32,000 into 100. And administration overhead, 1,00,000 divided by factory cost into 100. This is the problem. And then on the basis of above information, first you prepare the cost sheet. On the basis of this, on the basis of the above information, assuming that the unit will cost 2,500 towards material, 1,500 towards direct wage, productive wage, and prepare quotation. You have to prepare the quotation. First you prepare actual cost sheet, then prepare the quotation. One is for actual cost sheet, another is for quotation. In the quotation, first material 2,500, labor 1,500. Total is, 4,000 prime cost. To this, you add factory overhead. Factory overhead is, as you calculated, percentage. Percentage calculated, 25%. 25% of labor. Labor is 1,500. 25% of 1,500 you take, that is the 25% of 1,500 is the factory overhead. Okay. 375. You add it, you will get the factory cost. On the basis of factory cost, you add administration overhead. Administration overhead is, percentage calculated is 3.58% on work cost. On the work cost you calculate 3.58%. Okay. 3.58% on the work cost. Work cost is 4,000 is the prime cost. Factory overhead is 25% on labor. Four thousand three seventy five into 3.58. You add, then add the required percentage of profit. Percentage of profit is 20% on cost. Okay, whatever cost comes to that, you add 20%. You will get the profit. First, you prepare the actual cost sheet, then prepare the quotation. Quotation is material, labor, factory overhead, 25% on factory overhead, 25% on labor cost, present labor cost. And administration overhead is 3.58% on factory cost. You add, you will get the total cost. On the total cost, add 20% profit. You will get the quotation price. Okay, and this 33 is solved, 34 is also solved, 34 problem is also solved one. Then the example number 35. In the example number 35, from the following information, you are required to prepare statement showing prime cost, cost of production, total cost, percentage of work on cost. Work on cost means factory overhead. To productive wage means direct wage. It is always based on factory overhead is always based on direct wage. And percentage of office and general on cost means administration overhead. Administration overhead always depends on work cost. Okay. You take the opening stock of raw material, add purchases, less closing stock. You will get raw material consumed. Second item, wages, direct wage. Third item, direct expense, not given the problem. You take the total, you will get prime cost. To the prime cost, add factory overheads, 1,60,000. You will get factory cost. Then add administration overhead, 1,40,000. You will get cost of production. To that cost of production, you add opening finished stock and less closing finished stock. Less closing finished stock. You will get the cost of goods sold. Cost of goods sold. There is no selling expense. And you leave one line, take this sale. Sale is 25 lakh. Sale is 25 lakh. Difference is profit or loss. Whatever difference comes, that is the profit or loss. Okay. Profit or loss. Then you calculate the percentage. Works over percentage is equal to works overhead divided by direct wage. 1,60,000 is the works overhead divided by direct wage is 8 lakh. 1,60,000 divided by 8 lakh is equal to into 100 is equal to 20%. And in the same way you calculate administrative overhead percentage. Administrative overhead percentage is equal to administrative overhead 1,40,000 divided by cost of production. As per your calculation, you take the cost of production multiply by 100. That is administration overhead percentage. And next you have to prepare the quotation. In the quotation, you take material 80,000, wages 40,000. Total is 1,20,000 prime cost. On this, you add factory overhead. Factory overhead percentage you calculated, that is 20%. Okay, 20% of rupees 40,000, that is 8,000 is the factory overhead. Then 80 plus 40, 1,20,000 plus 8,000, 1,28,000. 1,28,000 is the factory cost. Okay. 1,28,000 is the factory cost. To that factory cost, add administration overhead. Administration overhead, as per your calculation, 5%. 5% of 1,28,000. 5% of 1,28,000 is, I think it is 6,400. You add 6,400, you will get cost of production. Cost of production. Then 20% profit on selling price. Okay. Total cost of production, add profit. Profit is equal to total cost into 20 divided by 80. You add profit, you will get the quotation price. Quotation price. Okay. Then example number 36. Example number 36. You see the example number 36. In the example number 36, a manufacturer of Narmada brand scooter finds that in 1987, it cost him 21,60,180 to manufacture 180 scooter. Their cost is 21,60,180 is the cost to manufacture 180 scooters. If you divide by 180, you will get cost for scooter. Okay, cost for scooter, which he sell for ₹16,200 each. Price per scooter is 16,200. Price per scooter is 16,200. 16,200 is the price per scooter. Then the material cost. Material cost is 8,46,000. Direct wage is 9,72,000. Factory on cost means factory overhead. Factory overhead 1,45,800. Office overhead is 1,96,380. Okay. If you divide these amounts by 180 number of scooters, you will get the cost per scooter. Cost per scooter means cost per unit. Okay. Then you take the selling price per scooter is 16,200 per unit and multiply by 180. Multiply by 180, you will get the total sale. Then total sale and total cost difference is the profit or loss. Profit or loss. Okay. And for the next year, he estimates, their estimation for the next year, each scooter will require material 4,800. Per scooter material rate is, material required is 4,800. Labor required is 5,400. 5,400. Then that the factory on cost means factory overhead bear the same relation to wages. Same relation to wages means there is a proportionate, means you have to consider the proportionate expense based on the previous factors, the relation between the wages of the previous period. Whatever the relation between wage and factory overhead is there in the year 1987, the same relation will be maintained in the next period. Okay. Same percentage you have to take. So it is better to calculate the percentage. Okay, we will calculate percentage. The office and office overhead percentage on factory cost will same as in the past. That is also same percentage. Okay. And prepare a statement showing the profit he would make per scooter if he reduces the selling price by ₹600. They wants to reduce the selling price by ₹600. 600 means existing selling price is 16,200. 16,200 is the existing selling price. They would like to reduce by 600. Means new selling price will be 16,200 minus 600. I think it is 15,600. Selling price will be 15,600. Okay. And multiply by 180 scooters, you will get total amount. In the adjustment, they have given the per unit 4,800 material cost, 5,400 labor, factory overhead percentage you have to calculate based on the per unit. Okay. In the note, they have given the calculation. Factor over percentage is 15% and administration overhead is 10%. Okay. These two percentage, 4,800 material, 5,400 labor. Total is, I think it is 10,200. 10,200 material cost. And 15% of 5,400 is the wages. You add, you will get the factory cost. And 10% of that new factory cost is the administration overhead. You add, then you will get cost of production and add profit. Sorry, you take selling price, leave one line and take the selling price. Selling price is 15,600 per unit and multiply 180, you will get total sale. difference between cost and sale is called as profit. Okay, these are the 15 mass questions in the Balyar book. I solved the different examples. I already solved the different examples. On the basis of those examples, you solve all the examples in your notebook. And I'll see those examples during the offline class. So you solve 5 mass questions, then solve the 15 mass questions serially one by one. And if you have any problems, you can call me or you can share the problem with your friends and get it clear. Okay. And today I will complete the second unit, that is elements of costing. Second unit is classification of cost or elements of cost. And first unit is the introduction of costing, that is already taught by Dr. B.M. Hiramal sir. And I'll take the next unit, that is material, in the next class. So you have to solve all the 5 mass questions and 15 mass questions in your notebook. I already uploaded in my Google Drive. You go through the exercise and solve all the problems one by one and be perfect. Okay. You discuss regarding your doubts in your friend circle, and suppose you are unable to solve the problem in group also, then you call me, I'll give the solved answer or I'll explain. Okay, thank you. We'll see tomorrow. Today I muted your audio video strictly. Okay. Suppose you are any heavy, if suppose you are having doubts, or if you want to talk in the middle, you send your problem in the chat box. Tomorrow notes. Okay, only 2 minute time is there. And I'll conclude here only.